Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Welcome again to Coffee and the Word. Grab your cup. Let's get into the Word and take a couple minutes today and talk about how our faith has to be in God and how we have to believe the right thing about God. You know, so many people are destroyed and defeated today because they don't know the source of their problem. They think it's maybe God. Maybe God put this on me. Maybe God is the one who's trying to teach me something. We've heard all kinds of religious teachings about how God puts sickness on you to bring you into humility and to bring you into, you know, whatever. And if you believe that God is the source of your problem, you'll never have faith in Him. You'll never be able to believe. So what you believe about God will determine whether your faith works for you or whether your faith is hindered. Notice he says in Hebrews 11:6, but without faith, it's impossible to please God, for he who comes to God must believe. Notice he says, when you come to God, you have to believe something. And he says, here's what you have to believe, that he is and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. You can't come to God and believe he's the cause of your sickness or the cause of your pain or the cause of your problems. Well, I believe God put this on me to humble me. Well, that's contrary to the word. James and also in 1 Peter, they both say, for you to humble yourselves before God. So if I'm going to be humbled, it's up to me to make that choice. Well, maybe God put this on me to teach me something. No, John 16:13 says he sent the Holy Spirit to teach you. He's the teacher of the church, not sickness, disease, problems, poverty, lack, want, or anything else that's causing you to be oppressed and defeated. You see, you've got to find out what is the source of your problem. How can you fight until you know who your enemy is? 1 Timothy 6:12 says you're to fight the good fight of faith. So who is the source of my problems today? What is causing this? Well, in Acts 10:38, when the Apostle Peter was preaching to Cornelius, he said this, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. Now listen what he did, who went about doing good. Now what does God call good? Healing all who were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. So God was the healer. The devil was the one causing the sickness. God was the deliverer, and the devil was one causing the oppression. The Lord Jesus himself said this, so that we could understand and distinguish the source of blessing and the source of the problem. He said in John 10:10, the thief, who is the devil, comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But I've come that you may have life and that you may have it more abundantly. Notice that Jesus is the life giver. The devil is the killer. Jesus is the one who wants to bless you. The devil wants to steal from you. See, you've got to settle that today. No matter what you're going through, it was not God who did it to you. It's God who wants to bring you out of it. It's the devil that's causing the problems. And you know, just to go ahead and seal this little teaching up to you so that you understand, notice what James chapter 1 here, down here in verse 12 says. He says, blessed is the man who endures temptation. That word temptation is tests and trials. Notice you get blessed when you endure it, when you make it through it. You don't get blessed while you're going through it. You get blessed when you figure out how to get to the other end of it. Notice he says, blessed is the man who endures temptation, for when he has been approved, he will receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised to those who love him. Now listen to this next one. Let no man say when he is tempted, I'm tempted by God, for God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he tempt, test, or try anybody with evil. Sickness, disease, oppression is from the devil. Poverty, lack, and want is a part of the curse, and it's the source of that is the devil. So what do you need to do today? You need to believe that God is going to be the one that's going to reward you with health, healing, deliverance, and set you free, and do what the Apostle Peter said in chapter 5. He said this. Of his first letter, he writes and he says this, be sober, be vigilant, because your enemy, your adversary, the devil, is out to steal, kill, and destroy, and rob you and plunder you as a roaring lion. He's roaming about, seeking whom he may devour. But what does he say? Whom resists steadfast in the faith. What's he saying? You stand today against your true enemy, and that's the devil. And you put your faith in God, who is your true lover and healer and deliverer, and you watch your faith begin to get you the victory. Amen? Today, say, Mr. Devil, you will have no more place in my life. I know you're the cause of this now, and I resist you in Jesus' name. And then you need to say, Lord Jesus, I believe you today that you reward me with my deliverance, healing, and victory, and I believe it's so. And begin to claim your blessings. Amen. God loves you today. Stand strong. Walk in faith. And until next time, I'm praying for you that God's very best will be yours.